Let's talk a little bit. I want to go into the topic Mark Hegarty brought up. He talked about gender division and negative campaigning. Being unable to be a hands-on father, I fill the hole in my heart by trying to create change as a way to support my daughter. I'm not in her immediate world, but I can try to positively influence the world around her. And he's setting up an organization in the UK, and he's actually here from the UK in this webinar. He's aimed at educating men on how they can support women as a precursor to prevent domestic violence. Please, go ahead. Okay, Mark Hegarty, why don't you share a little bit about yours? And I know there are several people on here that can relate to this. In fact, Mark Ludwig being, and several of you are fathers, targeted fathers.
Okay. Well, a lot of, certainly in the UK, I see a lot of this huge, huge, huge gender division in the UK at the moment. And I see it a lot within the parental alienation community. But certainly more so in the UK. There was, I'm not sure if you're aware of this, a very high profile murder of a lady called Sarah Everard, who was murdered by a police officer whilst walking home a couple of months back. It started a huge campaign, which led to a lot of media, a lot of aggressive media, which you see. And this all come about from a conversation with a friend who said to me, what's it like being the enemy? And I said, what do you mean? She says, as a white, straight, middle-aged man. And I thought that's a really good conversation because, you know, I support Black Lives Matter. I support gay rights. I support women's rights. I support all these things. However, there's a lot of media focused on aggressive about men being wrong, men not doing these things. And the situation that we discussed that come about is I'm always in a rush to get places. And I'm sure you've all been in the situation where you're walking home and you have to overtake somebody, you know, a lady who's in front of you, and you don't know what to do. If you hold back, you're worried that, you know, she might think that you're ready to pounce. If you rush past her, she might think you're actually going to pass. And I just thought, what can I do in this situation? And that sort of led to other conversations about, you know, well, what as a man, what can I do to try and make women feel safe? Because I haven't seen my daughter. It'll be 5 years that I haven't seen my daughter. And I really miss, as I'm sure, you know, most parents who have been alienated miss being a parent. And I really miss being a father. And I thought, well, rather than because I can't to fill that gap that I have in my heart, I can try and do something as a man to try and change, to say that it isn't all, you know, not all men are rapists, not all men are domestic violence perpetrators. However, that kind of argument sometimes isn't an argument that's going to resolve the situation that we're in. So the campaign, which, fingers crossed, it's been picked up as a documentary. It's a journey that I've been through, is to find out what can I do as a man to support, to try and help women feel safe, rather than, you know, sort of being attacked, but take on all boards of all sides of the arguments. And then what I hope is that by, you know, coming up with a campaign that can be directed by and can be supported by men and by women, and also with campaigners who will say it's not all men, then with trying to get everybody involved in, let's do something positive, to say some kind of positive action that we can do as individuals. And by that, I don't want my daughter to be abused. Now, the fact is, maybe contentious, that it's likely that she's going to suffer some kind of abuse in her lifetime, because, you know, that's the kind of thing that women, you know, unfortunately, regressively go through. I can't stop her. Whilst I can't physically stop her from doing that, I may be able to try, and I'll do everything I can to try and change attitudes, to try and sort of, as a way to try and stop, you know, prevent you know, domestic violence from occurring. So, and then by sort of engaging with you know, hardline, you know, female campaigners, hardline male campaigners, as a lot of male, and try and, you know, once, if we can do something here, then maybe as a next step, then let's have the conversation about parental alienation, about false allegations. And yeah, that's...
I hear what you're saying, you know, a lot of times, I mean, and what I hear is you're trying to proactively do something positive, because I think all of us who are on this, on social media, they live, we hear frustrated people, and what do? We vent. We vent on Facebook, and you know, and it doesn't really serve. It doesn't serve us, and it doesn't serve the people who are reading our posts if we're bashing our ex or even focusing on the negative aspects of them. So I see that you're trying to make a change, just be a light. So that, you know, and be an example to your daughter.
And Danica, what I see in this situation is energy. It is, and unfortunately, it's a lot of it is, you know, understandably, is negative, angry energy. If we can harness that energy into doing something positive, then we really have an opportunity to do something, you know, to work together to try and create a positive change.
That's right. That's right. There's several of us, I think all of us, that you wouldn't have been invited if you were putting negativity back into the space. And I acknowledge each one of you for being part of the solution and not amplifying, you know, that discouraged, resignated space.